How's it going, guys? Today I'm going to be playing Bart versus the Space Mutants for NES. Now, this is a game that is notoriously well known for being a difficult platformer, and the controls in the game can be like a little bit weird, a little bit wonky when you're jumping around in certain parts. One thing I do want to say is that I did a playthrough of this game before recording this, and I have beaten this game before, so I wanted to do that because this is a game that requires a lot of trial and error. You need to know what you're doing. So I am pretty practiced. I know what to do. And one thing I wanted to show you is that when I got to the last level, is the power plant, and it's a pretty hard and it's a tough thing to navigate. So I made myself a little map so that I know what to do. So when you see me looking over there, you know, that's what I'm looking at. I'm looking at the map that I made. But yeah, let's get to it and start with stage one. And basically the idea is they're building this machine that they need, it says right here, it requires is one ingredient, purple colored objects. So you want to change the color of stuff, so I'll show you that in a second. So this is the first stage, and you see there's a purple colored object. What you want to do is you want to change the color of it. And let me check this guy out actually real quick. So the game is kind of like They Live, if you've ever seen that movie, where... and I'm going to get the spray can right now. Where in that movie, there are aliens walking amongst regular, you know, regular folk, and grabbing that guy too. And basically, in the movie, when you put on the glasses, you can see that people are aliens, and I think that that's probably where they got this from. Now you see, I just jumped on that guy's head before. What I was doing there is, you know, you put on the glasses, and then you see if the dude is an alien or not. And if he is, you jump on his head and kill him. And I'm gonna try to get this Krusty the Clown thing. Now, the Krusty the Clown icons are, there we go. Those are extra lives. And look, they're playing Space Mutants 4. So yeah, there's a lot of things you need to know about the game. You can call the phone, and it tells jokes right there. But I'm gonna skip that. See, again, I covered up the purple objects. We don't want anything that's purple. Although, Bart's pants look a little purple, so... are we gonna be taking Bart's pants off? Oh, God. Is it subliminal messages here? Gotta be really careful of the jumping in this game. Because that's the main thing about this game that's hard, is the jumping. And I guess knowing what to do on certain parts to a certain extent. Okay, see, that's a regular dude. He doesn't have the antennas. So I'm going inside here, and what am I doing? I'm gonna get a wrench that you use for this right here. You hit the select button, and you can toggle through the different items, and then you hit start, and see, I just turned that object, that banner, red. So that's pretty much what you're doing here. Turn everything red. We're painting the roses red. That guy's also regular. Here we want, I think, one cherry bomb is all we need for the dog, I think. And then I want a bunch of those. Those are important. And I got another coin if I need to come back for anything else. Turn that red. Painting the planters red. The toys, you know, I don't really remember. I think the whistle you use for the retirement home to get coins or something, but I'm not entirely sure. I don't really remember. I can't remember every single thing about this, even though I have beaten it before. That sucks that I just missed that. But we'll see if I can get enough items anyway. Oh, never mind, I got it. See, I was worried there for a second because I thought that was the only way you could get it was by hitting that ball, but you can just walk up there and hit it. The pet store, you can't go in there. But what we are gonna do with this pet store thing is, I'm gonna use the cherry bomb right now, hit start, and that scares away that bird. That's how you do that. And I think there's a dog that comes here. I thought there was anyway. You gotta be quick about this one. Well, at least I turned him purple. That's really all that matters. I got hit, but what are you gonna do? And I'm gonna use the rocket here. Oops. Use the rocket, hit the bird, that's how you get him off of the statue, get the bird off the statue. And on this part, we're gonna be riding on a skateboard, classic Simpsons right here. and we're going to be attacked in a second by, if you guys remember the early episodes of The Simpsons, Jimbo Jones was the one of the bullies, but we're going to be fighting the other bully. Oh, damn, I missed that. Shit, can I get that? There. I don't know if I... Yeah, I guess I didn't get it. But yeah, that's Jimbo Jones from the early episodes. I don't know if they used him later on. I haven't watched all 8 million seasons of The Simpsons. I think I stopped watching in the first, 5 years or so. And I've caught episodes here and there since. So, turn the water fountain there. Okay, that's a regular dude. Barney's Bolarama. Again, you use the fireworks for that. The rocket. And, yep, another dude. So there you go. You can see I just got the eye for Maggie. Now what that does basically, oh wait, also I want to show you this little tip too. You want to be running here, and if you are, like this, you can run right under those guys. And there's another alien. And I just spell that Maggie. And damn it, that was a B. That's too bad. So when I get to the end of the stage and I have to fight Nelson, basically Maggie will help you out by, I think she throws bowling balls out or something. She does something that helps you. Which you don't necessarily need it, but, it's helpful. Got another coin. It's another alien. Didn't really need that. Now right here, if you hit this E, you can get an extra life thing. I'm gonna try it. Oh! You have to know where to stand. I didn't know exactly. That's tough to get. See, that's the kind of thing, like, through trial and error and different stuff, you learn that kind of stuff, like where to stand right there or else you miss it. So clearly I need a little more practice. And the retirement home here, I think this is where I use the whistle, but I didn't bother to get it. The reason I didn't is because I tried to conserve the coins, because I feel like you need them. And again, gonna use another rocket. And that's it, goal is achieved, so we're going to the right. And we're gonna fight. I'm not gonna bother with that. I'm gonna fight Nelson. Ha ha! See, yeah, it is the bowling balls. Damn it. There we go. I think it's like 3 or 4 bowling balls and he'll be dead. Maybe one more. Come on. There you go. And that's level 1. I've heard a lot of people say they've never even gotten past level 1 in this game. But basically, it's just, you need to know what to do. Once you know what to do, it's really not that difficult. But the difficulty is going to come on this next stage with the platforming. The next stage is the mall. And this is where it definitely starts to get hard. Because you have to jump on these candy cane things, you'll say. Alright, level 2 here. I am grabbing that guy's cap, because the goal of this level is to collect hats and jump on Marge's head. Marge with her hair down. Now, she was a space alien. And that theme continues through the game. So you gotta also watch out for bouncing lifesavers and marshmallows on this level. I just collected Charles Nelson Reilly's hat there. Alright, this is where it gets hard. Alright. Whoa. Alright, I was calling these candy canes earlier. They're lollipops. And you have to wait for them to be horizontal. Alright. There we go, and let's grab Krusty, and watch out for the lifesavers. It's Let's grab the hat. I'm not terribly concerned about that. Oh, there's candy canes. See, I'm not totally crazy. Just mostly crazy. Alright. Oh my god, that was close. Alright. It's Mr. Skinner. Or it's Principal. That's who I always thought this guy was. I don't know if he actually is. Tossing fucking Reese's Pieces at me. Actually, you can jump on the trash can sometimes and get, like, coins and shit. Let's see. Not there. Let's see if I can grab this hat. There we go. Confections by Clyde. I never really read the store names. Not gonna pay more attention to that. 52% off. Mop Top Shop. Whoa, hang on a second. Alright. Let me get that hat. I remember there's Michael Jackson's, like, moonwalking shoes in this, too. I think they're coming up. Converse. Are these? Yeah, she's a space alien. I want to get that. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Alright, so, I'm trying to spell out Marge. Ballet shoes. Oh, there's a coin. Gimme that. Alright, like loafers. Cowboy hat. Fuck. They sort of trick you there. Oh, I just got an extra crusty. Alright, we got hopping cleats here. Whoa, that was really close. You gotta be careful here not to get stunned. These shoes are gonna be a problem. Give me that cowboy hat. Oh, space alien. And a hat. And we're on the G on Marge. And there is Michael Jackson's moonwalking shoes. Moonwalker. There we go. Spring shoes, all kinds of crazy shit. Hope there's no more of the spring shoes. Oh god. It's Mr. Skinner in a fucking boot now. Okay, I got him. Got his hat, too. Damn it. That's two. Whoa. That's three. Fucker. And look at all this. Oh, I thought I could grab it. That's a shoe, not a hat. Oh! Do you guys get that joke? Look at that. It's the really big shoe. I think that's supposed to be like an Ed Sullivan thing, because he used to do that. I don't know if anybody's gonna get that reference of fucking Ed Sullivan, but I'm pretty sure that's what the joke is there. It's gonna be a really big shoe. Whoa. Alright. Oh, it's the magic shop. He's having an accident, apparently. And we got another Krusty coming up. They give you plenty of those, I will say. Alright. Fuck. Damn rabbits. Tricks are for kids. Oh, fucker. Well, I have Marge spelled out, but I need three more hats. Oh, can I get this one? There we go. If I just wait around long enough. Collecting the hats on this stage is not really too tough. Alright, here's the magic trick again. I think they did that magic trick on an episode of the Brady Bunch. Oh boy. Alright. I get that off the fucking screen. I'm just getting could buy this rabbit. One more hat's all we need. Come on, lady. Alright, we got a tie. Maybe it's a handkerchief, I don't know. Alright, that was the last one. Now I think the boss of this level, I guess I'm coming up on it. Oh god, we got more fucking platforming shit. Alright, here we go. Fuck. How far can I get over here? Alright. Okay, hang on. Alright. Okay. Got the hat that I didn't even need. Oh boy. Okay. The one ring to rule them all. They give you plenty of hats. That's not even really a concern. I'm gonna jump over this, I think, by... maybe I'll go under. Okay. I'm just being extra careful. I could be going quicker, but... We got another Mr. Scanner to fight? Yeah, I think it's the last one. Sort of disappears and reappears. One more. There's the magic shop. And we're coming up on the last boss. Grab the derby just for good luck. Not doing too bad. 6 lives. I guess that's okay. And I think this is Mrs. Botts from the Babysitter Bandit episode, which is an early episode. So you pretty much just do this. Marge helps a bit because she knocks some of these out of the way, which it could like hit you on the head, which is good. Should be coming up soon. Come on. Is she dead? There you go. That is level 2. Very tough level, and usually a lot of people don't get past that one because of the platforming. Jumping on those lollipops and stuff is... definitely really hard. Now, level 3 is one that I really liked as a kid, and I thought it was fun because it was like, you can play all these different crusty carnival games, like popping balloons and stuff like that, and you'll see that here. It's a lot of fun. So, on this stage, the goals are the balloons. You can either use a slingshot, or you can just grab the balloons. That guy's not a space alien. Like killer clowns from outer space here. So you turn on the coins and hit up to play these games, and if you can hit 3 in a row on this one, 3 of these like sphinx heads, boom, there you go. And I won. What did I get? You win. Oh, space alien, hang on. Oh, we got a Krusty actually, so that's good. And this is another space alien. Look at that, killing it with the Lisas. Killer clowns hopping around. Yeah, so this one, I don't think there's any rhyme or reason. You just pick, and no matter what, I think it's an extra life if you win it. And, alright, so I got it, and you win. So exciting, oh my god. But this is a good place to collect extra lives, definitely. So there are a few more of these carnival games, but I'm not going to play them because I had 9 lives, and I think 9 is the most you can get. I don't think it rolls over past the 9 on screen there, so. Grab a balloon from that dude. And there's the slingshot. Slingshot, as you can see right there, you can, you know, shoot balloons out of the sky and get more. You get another one. Watch out for the killer clowns here. And what I'm gonna do is jump off of this thing over to the left and hopefully land on the thing. There we go. Fuck. I'm making a jump for it anyway, so. Alright, let's do it. Here we go! Nice. Superman! And collect the... oh, the Jebediah Springfield head, and... the coins, and jump over that dude, and there should be another coin. There it is, rolling away. quickly. Just gonna grab these. Is this the dude he's sitting on a, like a thing where he falls into the water? I will say this is one level where collecting the goals is really easy because with those flying in the sky, it's just like you can keep grabbing them pretty much. Or shooting them with your slingshot or whatever. And this is not a space alien, and that dude almost hit me. Oh, getting by these cherry bombs is a bitch! Fuck you. Let me get him out of here. Alright. Unfortunately, I got hit there. Oh, here you go. Alright, got three of the least of things. And there's another slingshot. Gonna grab that for some extra shots if I can grab it. Whoa, watch out for that. And there you go. Already got Lisa. Surprisingly. That was really quick. Another balloon. And we're going into the funhouse. I think if you do this, it's probably just... it's probably just an extra Krusty, but I'll try it, I guess. You pretty much just keep selecting these doors. I don't know like what the rhyme or reason to this is. There we go. Did I do it? No. Come on. Yeah, I don't know exactly what you're supposed to do there. That I never quite understood. Shit. There we go. I'm waiting for the balloon here. But you see these air pockets, you gotta ride on those to get over here. That kind of thing. Come on. There we go. It's a little timing there to make sure that you don't fall and die. Careful, these guys rolling around. Alright. Let me knock this dude out of there. Whoa! Gotta be careful. Go. There's an extra life if you jump down here, but I'm not gonna go for it because I feel like I would die. But it's in Krusty's mouth. And I've got 9 lives anyway, so not really much of a purpose. Because I think 9 is the most you can get. Alright, got that. Another one of those, and then you just keep walking the right, and we are out of the funhouse. Grab more. Whoa! Whoa! The hardest part of this level is avoiding these clowns that walk by like that, because they just like come out of nowhere. Especially the ones that roll off of the balloons in the air are really hard to avoid. Sometimes there'll be a clown on one of those balloons, and if you knock them down, they come rolling along like that. Like this, right here. Like that. That can be tough sometimes, but I did well. Alright, we're almost at the end, except I don't have enough of the goals really yet. And there's an extra life you can get, but again, I have enough, so. Six more goals. See, now this is the end, but I just don't have enough. I wonder if these will just keep coming. That would be nice. Come on, balloons. So at the end of this, oh god, I'm not even gonna have enough time, am I? I'm gonna run out of time, but at least in the meantime, maybe I'll get all the goals. But you fight Sideshow Bob, and he's really easy. He just jumps around, and then you just jump on his feet. But unfortunately, I'm gonna run out of time, probably because I spent so much time playing the little mini games. Can I get? I have 2 seconds to get all the balloons. Oh, look at that! Alright, but I should be able to do it here. There we go. I'll get it right here. Alright, so I got all the goals now. I'm just gonna head to the end. This is a hard level to do on your first attempt because... I mean, I guess if you don't play the mini-games, then that's how you do it. But I always play the mini-games. And I know I could grab that, but whatever. Let's fight Sideshow Bob. And there's Lisa. How you doing, Lisa? Is she gonna help out at all? She's not doing much, is she? Come on, get him. Did that even hurt him? I don't even know. Because you have to jump on his feet, so I would think that that has to... Oh, it stuns him, I say. Alright. There we go. So one more hit. Come on, Sideshow. Come on. There we go. Oh, maybe it's more than three hits. Never mind. Shit. There it is. Wow, is it more than four hits? Damn. Surprising. There we go. So it's five hits. I actually thought it was three for some reason. I guess you would expect it to be three. But that is that. Usually I actually don't even get Lisa on that. I don't even know if I ever got Lisa before on that level, to tell you the truth. He's not hard at all to fight. Very easy boss. The bosses in this game are not really what's difficult. It's the platforming, really. Now this level, speaking of difficult, I think that this is the hardest level in the game, so here we go. Alright, so yeah, I do think that this is the hardest level in the game. The last level is pretty tough too, but it's tough in a different way. Because the last level is like a maze, sort of. This is hard because there's hard platforming. Right there, I just got a goal. You'll see the goals is a lot less on this. You know, there's only six here. And you can get these out by, like, bouncing, but I never quite figured out what the deal is. Okay, here's the space alien. I'm gonna get him out. Yeah, that's one thing I never quite understood. If anybody, like, want to leave a comment and let me know how you get those, like, crusties out of there. I think you just jump on it, but I was jumping on it and it wasn't coming out, so... Shit. There's also a space alien. See these? Can I get these out? Sometimes you jump on them and they come out, and other times it doesn't work. Like that! See? There it came out. I mean, maybe just, like, wait on it longer? I'm not sure. Yeah. It's like the outdoor prehistoric part of the museum. Got more dark gun, that's good. And oh my god, this is gonna be a jump and a half. Oh my god, and you gotta make those noises too, by the way. Sounds like you're taking a shit. Constipated. Okay, so this part always reminded me of Pitfall for Atari 2600. Alright, well, I'm not gonna go down in the bottom because there's a spider, and I don't think you can shoot it with the dart. So, I'm gonna jump from up here. Tough jumps to make. And these guys are sinking, and like... And there's dragonflies to avoid. It's unbelievable. Alright, well, he's like sinking and shit. Oh my god. This is ridiculous. Whoa! And then I'm getting like coconuts shot in my fucking face. Fucking monkeys that look like Homer Simpson. That monkey was funny looking. Avoid the dragonflies. This part sort of reminds me of a section in Adventure Island near the end. There's a part that has a lot of spiders. I think it's kind of near the end of the game. This is like a little mini boss. It's like, feed me, Seymour! Little Shop of Horrors. The dart gun here is helpful because it kind of freezes him. There we go. Again, use the dart gun to shoot the exit signs. Sky Space Alien, come on. Oh, fuck, I missed him. Alright. It's all about the timing on that. Let's see if I can get this. I'm not quite sure what you do exactly, but if you it's kind of like if you fuck around with it enough, they pop out. Somebody let me know in the comments. Like, see, it comes out if you fuck around with it enough, but it's like, I don't know what exactly you're supposed to be doing there. I'm gonna do it with this crusty too, because it'd be nice to have an extra life. Come on. I know that if I fuck with this enough, it'll come out. Well, I'm wasting time. There it goes. See, like, it came out there. So please explain to me what you do. Is it just that you have to wait a little while? Is that what it is? Or is there something you have to do with the D-pad? Like, I just don't get that part. Alright, I'm almost out of time, but maybe I can... Got the exit sign at least, and I have like 2 seconds left, so... This part coming up is like a platforming section that's kind of difficult. Wait for these lasers. Come on, alien. So I only have one goal left, so that shouldn't be a problem. But I have to now make it... Wait, out of the way of the space alien, playing it safe. Alright. There we go. This part is hard. There we go. I know I'm like wasting a dart every time. I also don't know what to do to like not shoot those. Okay, come on. Alright. Okay, oh my god. Okay, so this part, you have to wait for these fucking things. I'm not sure. Alright, I guess I'm just going for it. Oh my god, it's shit pickle. Shit pickle. Too bad James isn't here, he can do the voice. It's like a hand, actually. It's like a green hand. It looks like fucking shit pickle, though. It's shit pickle. Come on. Alright, jump over these fucking snakes. Fuck you. Now we got, like, daggers and shit. This is nuts. Oh, yeah, I remember this part. So, here, you have to get the... Whoa. Watch out for the beetles. You have to do this kind of shit, and then the, I think they're called, aren't they called onks or whatever? And you get these out, and then it raises this, like, little platform in the middle. And then what you do, actually, fuck. What you do is, if I can get these, you stand on top of it, and then the thing lowers, eventually. If you can do it, I don't know if I can do it yet. Not yet. I think I need another one. There we go. Alright, it might be now. Yeah, see, now the thing's lowering. Fuck! Let me try it again. Let's do it again. Because I fucked it up. But it lowers, and then it, like, opens the next section up. I guess it, I think it starts with... Is this one it starts with? It's this one. Did I not trigger it out far enough? Now it might be. There we go. So that's one. You have to jump like high enough. I think you have to jump up to where their like heads are. Never know which one has it. These things are hard to avoid, these little like spiders, beetles, or whatever they are. Okay. See, I get so excited about getting the ankh. I think they're called ankhs, aren't they? The Egyptian ankh. Alright, so that's lowering. And I also gotta watch out for this shit falling. It's like snowflakes. but then the next section will open up. Hopefully. Come on. There we go. Oh, and of course I got hit. I was like standing right on top of where the spike was. Alright, now there's monkeys and shit. Fucking flying monkeys. See, now it's getting hard. Now I gotta do this again. Third fucking time. Oh, they don't make you do it again. Well, that's good, at least. That is really good. I'm actually really surprised that they don't make you. And of course, I got hit. Shit, this is getting hard now. I told you, this is the level that I have the hardest time with, for sure. Thank God they don't make you do that again. That is one thing forgiving about this game, that they don't make you redo that. There's not much forgiving, but there's that. I hate these monkeys. Cats. Egyptian cats, whatever the fuck they are. Alright, there we go. Is it like Homer? It's like Mummy Homer. There we go. Alright. Another alien. Ugh, fucking missed him too. Damn it. Definitely not gonna get that. I hate to say. I gotta really get that. Alright, so. Oh. Come on. Ugh, I was facing the wrong direction now. I'm falling apart now. There we go. Final goal. That was fucking hard to get. Let's see if I can get this Jebediah Springfield head. That would be helpful, at least. And then the next section is also really fucking hard, by the way. Come on, come out. Come out, come out, wherever you are. There it is. Just run through everything. Oh, you know what? I need that, though. I'm gonna try to get the crusty head as well. Come out, wherever you are. Come on, crusty. There he is. I think it's just like a matter of waiting, honestly. There we go. Maybe I'll make Homer yet. Fuck. Or not. Man, I'm fucking falling apart. It's a good thing I got that crusty. Okay. Oh, they don't give you the Jebediah head again? That fucking sucks. Alright. I'm gonna play it safe. This fucking level. This is definitely the hardest level of the game, I think. Never got by this when I was a kid. Oh, I hate this jump. Alright. That fucking jump sucks. I think that that's one of the hardest parts, because of the hardest jumps, because of the weird perspective on it. And then there's this shit with these fucking golden geeses. Gooses. Geeses. I want to have a gold egg for Easter. Veruca. She's a bad egg. No, but this whole part sucks because the platforming is like really tough. And you gotta avoid these fucking duck things. Gooses. It's just tough. Okay. Come on, I think this is the end of it. Oh my god. Alright, now what? Oh! Oh my god! You jump up here. I've done this before. I remember the first time I did this, I had no fucking clue what to do. You kind of like jump up and down, and then you jump on his head, and then you jump down, and then you jump back up. He opens his mouth, and so that's what you do. You have to like jump up and down. Oh, and there's the exit sign. But I've already completed the goals a little while ago, so I'm good on that. Not a space mutant. I'm not gonna get Homer, unfortunately. I don't think I am. Unless a bunch come at the last second. Whoa, almost hit him on the head. That's not good. Okay. This jumps. Oh, fuck! It's Dr. Marvin Monroe! If you remember, I think from the first episode of The Simpsons, I believe, and that was him. That stage is fucking crazy. The part where you're going through with the jumping on the dinosaurs with the golden geese and all that, I think that's the hardest part probably. And jumping over the laser beams can be hard. That whole thing. But anyway, this is the power plant. And this is the part where I'm going to actually be using this a little bit. And actually, if you hang on one second, I'm going to tape this so that I can see it. So I made myself this map, which I'll show it to you really quickly. If you want to see it. I drew this because I played this game before, and I just beat this before so that I knew what I was doing. So I'm taping this right here, and I'm like wasting all my time, I know. But yeah, I'm going to be using my map that I drew. So here we go. Alright, so you have to excuse me, I'm going to be pausing it a little bit so that I know where the heck I'm going. Alright, so to the right here is the first one. Okay, so there's Lisa, and she tells you the floor number, which I have written down. It's 14 on this floor. But the idea here, basically, is you have to collect them all. Those are the goals on this level. And the thing with Lisa that you just saw there, she tells you how to get through the doors. And now I'm going to go to the left, and she gave me the code of 14. So 14 is what I enter to get through the door on this level. Just like a little bit of a puzzle to figure out, basically. See? And I'm through the door. So thank you, Lisa. There's a box of donuts for Homer. That can come in handy when you want to get rid of a lot of the space mutants. I might do that in a little bit. And Marge is actually also part of this. Okay, yeah, this is another one of these things. Let me grab it real quick if I can. I'm like the Toxic Avenger here. Waiting for the right timing on this. Come on. I just fucking jump through it. Taking a risk, but whatever. Come on. This is like all bad timing. There we go. All right. Now we're going to go up the stairs. And there's a rod on this. Oh, and there's also a crusty, so let me grab that. That couldn't possibly be easier to get, could it? There's another one. All right, got that one. And each floor is color-coded, which my little map that I drew is color-coded too. So, floor 1 is gray, floor 2 is purple, floor 3 we're going up to right now, which is green. I'll grab the donuts, I guess. Am I going to go on this? I'm not going to go up that just yet. I'm going to keep going to, there's the blue floor, there's nothing on this one. It's really saving time for this playthrough that I have this map. And this one, this is the 5th floor, this is the top floor, and I'm grabbing, this is going to be hard to get though. I knew I was going to get hit there. But anyway, so now I'm going down. And I'm going to go down another level. And then I'm going to go over to the right. Now normally you wouldn't know this because you have to find Lisa first and she tells you the passwords to get through the doors. But I already know the passwords. So the password on this green level is 11. And also, it's not randomized, it's always the same, so if you play this game too, if the password's gonna be 11, watch, it should work. There you go. So there, it's always the same. It's always the same passwords. So yeah, I mean, hopefully you guys can use this as a little bit of a walkthrough if you decide to play this game through yourself. I don't think that this is a bad game. I just think that the platforming's really hard. Oh, and then Marge. Come on, Marge. See, she'll take the... If you see her, she really helps, actually, because she takes those down to the basement, which is where you gotta go, and that saves you time. So here I want to go up a level. Yeah. I want to go... Sorry, I'm just trying to figure this out. And there's a one rod over here, which... Actually, let me grab... get this crusty too if I can. Oh, can I not jump on that? Let's see. Oh, there's she. See, she's dropping them off. Oh, yeah. Okay, I can jump on this. There we go. Got another crusty. Doing quite well right now. Alright, got that. Alright. And then we're gonna go up another floor to the fifth floor. Oops. There we go. The elevators work differently than the stairs. So here I'm gonna go left. There should be one over to the left, but there's gonna be a door. And again, I already know the passwords. What am I doing? I was not paying attention. I was narrating and not paying attention to the game. See, that's what happens. That right there was a good example of, you know, trying to narrate for a video and not paying attention to the game, because there's no reason I would normally make that mistake. Alright, so the combination on this is 21. And... oh, that should be over here. So yeah, like, this level is not really that hard. Not like the other level. It doesn't have a ton of, like, tough platforming. There's a few parts that are a little tough, but, you know, nothing crazy. And the couple parts on this that are harder to jump by, like those aliens, you can use, like, Homer, so... Again, alright, so 21. So the last level is really not that bad if you've done it before and know what you're doing. Where every time I do the museum, it's fucking hard. Because that's, you know, comes down to, like, skill. Alright, so now we're getting back in the elevator. And we're gonna go back down to floor 2, I guess? Yeah, we're going down to floor 2, which this is the basement, so this is floor 1, this is floor 2. And then I'm gonna start heading to the right here. Watching out for the space aliens. Just taking it slow, I don't wanna get killed or anything. And the code for this one is 32. The purple one is 32, which is floor 2. And we're gonna be taking the stairs. Okay. Okay, so here I'm gonna go down. Did I just go up by accident? I think I just went up. I'll get that in a second, but I wanna make sure I go down. Come on, get in there and go down. Okay, I want to grab this first. Alright. That was a really good jump. Alright, now I'm going to go back up. I actually have to come back down here, but we'll do that in a minute. Okay, so I need to get this one. You know what I think I'm going to do? I'm going to make this map available. I'll put it on my Twitter, I think. And... what I gotta say is, I actually looked up in Nintendo Power to see if there was a map, and there wasn't, so I had to draw this map on my own. You would think, like, Nintendo Power would have a really good map that they would have made back in the day, but I don't think it ever did, so I might be the first person to ever make a map of the damn power plant. Alright, so we gotta find the elevator here. Right, and the elevator should be right here. This is the main elevator. And we're gonna take it to the basement. To the basement. See, here we go. Now I'm dropping them off. That's 4 more. Now now we're gonna go back up to second level and go back to what we were just doing, which was on the blue. So I'm taking the staircase. So the staircases are all the way on the right and all the way on the left of the power plant, to give you an idea sort of how the layout of the power plant works. And there's a main elevator that runs right through the middle, which is the elevator I was just on. But then there's two other elevators, sort of in the middle. Hard to explain, but you can look at my map to understand it. And now we're going back up again to the blue. Shit. This would be a good, you know what? Maybe this is a good spot to use Homer. Not yet. I'll use him though. Alright, so yeah, again, this is 41. Okay, go through the door. And now I should be able to get it. See, I don't think it was my bad jumping, but we'll see in a second. Let's see if I get this on the first shot now. Yeah, see, it wasn't me. Knew I wasn't that terrible at jumping. alright, so, you know, I have a lot of donuts. Should I just fuck it and let's use a donut? There he goes. And it gets everything off the screen, so. And also, you got to see Homer Simpson, so there he is. Very helpful. Thank you, Homer. Wow, Homer actually did something helpful. And I keep going up that by accident. So right now I'm heading down to, I gotta get down to the elevator, which is, did I just go up by accident? Yeah, I did. I didn't mean to do that. I actually have to go down all the way to the gray level, which is the first floor. Get in the door and go down. There we go. Controls are a little weird on that. Alright, so, oh. Here's another pretty good part to use Homer. I'm just gonna use it again, because why not? Really helpful. Alright, so this is the other elevator, and I'm gonna take that up now to the third floor, which is, again, basement. And this goes up to the third. You'll notice this one doesn't go to certain floors. And there should be two on this, and you'll see Lisa. Let's go that way first so I can show you. Lisa should be over here somewhere. If my map is correct at all. I think she'll be, yeah, there she is, and she'll tell you that's where you find out the combination, but like I said, I already have them. So that's Lisa. Oh, and there's Maggie. Oh, so Maggie, let's remember that. She's on the green. Maggie, I think, is randomized. She could be anywhere in the power plant. So that's not something I have written down on my map, but the last thing you want to do is find Maggie. So when you see her, you have to remember where she was. And actually, wait, before I do this, let me go back down to the green because I just totally missed something here. There's another rod over here that I probably, I almost missed this. Let me do this. I want to make sure I get everything. And I can only get one more, unfortunately, unless Marge comes. And that would be nice if she would come. That's where I could really use her, like, right now. Because there's two on this. And Lisa's over here. Again. You know what? Fuck it, this is another good place to use Homer. Okay. And there's Lisa. I'll just do it just so you can see. She says 21. There's another box of donuts over there, which would be good for me to get. But see, I'm full now, so, and Marge is not coming, so now I have to go back. And I'm heading back to the main elevator to drop off these things, which is right over here. And take this down to the basement. There is no basement in the Alamo, you know. Alright, so we got three more to get, plus the final. So we're going back up to second floor. totally back to what we were doing. It's a little bit tedious, I know. So this is floor 32 again. Taking the stairs. Or no, I'm sorry, we're taking the elevator. So we're going down first to the gray. Take it over to the elevator. See, this would have been sped up a lot if Marge would have come again, but she did not. Good thing I made that. And again, we're taking this all the way to the top floor. And can I grab this crusty? That'd be nice. I don't really need it. Gonna grab this. Nice. Probably a good spot to use Homer. Do I even have any more, though? I don't have any more Homer. Fuck! Okay, now I want to try to get that. I bet it's on the other side. There, like that, yep. Nice. Alright, so I think that's everything there. And the other two, I'm pretty sure I know where they are. So I'm going back down to the first floor. And then I'm going to take the other elevator that there's only one of. Fuck. The other thing I might do is go get the other donuts real quick, just to play it safe. All the way up to the top floor, you know, I might as well do it. On the top floor in the top corner, which I actually did not write down all the donuts on my map, which I should have, but the top floor in the top corner has the donut, so I'm going to get more of those, just in case I happen to need them. But now I'm headed back down to the second floor, I believe. Yeah, and then I'm gonna go all the way across. I'm just making sure it's the right place. Yeah, okay, it's the second floor, and then I would go all the way across to get to the elevator. And I died, so I have a lot of time. Tedious stuff. I can imagine a lot of people not liking this level, but I like it. I think it's fun. I think it's creative. And, you know, what's cool about this game is each, you know, level sort of has its own puzzles to them and everything. What am I doing? Damn it. Not paying attention. But it's a creative game, you know? I think it is. It's just, I think people hate on it because of the platforming is really hard, which I can't really argue with. It is extremely difficult. Especially on that museum stage, it's a nightmare. So, that is a valid argument if you don't like the game because of the platforming. But other than that, like, I think it's pretty good. Okay, this is the other elevator I want to be in. And I'm going to take this up to, I think, the fourth floor, is it? No, I'm kind of forgetting. This is the one, but let me double check. I might have gotten this one already. Yeah, no, I didn't. So this is one of them. Okay. And then I only need one more, and then Maggie, who, if you remember, was on the green. And the other one is... It's actually the one I'm missing here, is right next to Lisa. There she is, see? And she, you know, she says the combination's 41, which I already knew because I had the map. And last but not least, we have to go back to the green. So I have to go, like, sort of down and around. Now I gotta go, I think, all the way over to the right set of stairs again. Oh, is she gonna take it? Take it, take it. There she goes. She's taking it down there for me. Thank you, Marge. Should be 32. Starting to remember them now. Can I, like, get it right? Okay. This game is also, I think it was also on Master System or Genesis too, believe it or not. Okay, only one more to get. So now I'm gonna take the doors are so weird. I'm gonna take the other elevator up, and And that should be where Maggie is on the green, I believe. So she's on the third floor. This should be her. Where is she? Where is she? This might just end the game if I can find her. Oh, or was she on a different part of the green area? Shit. She might have been. She might have been in that stair, in the stairwell, actually. But I'm just looking around for her real quick. You know what? I think she might have been in the stairwell. Oh, no, there she is. She wasn't appearing. Hey, Maggie. There it is. And that reminds me of the beginning of the actual, you know, Simpsons television show where she, like, has it, like, in her mouth, you know, on the... at the grocery store with Marge. But that's it, guys. That is Bart versus the Space Mutants for NES. The last level, it's a little bit confusing, I guess, like if you don't have a map or if you don't know what you're doing. But it's, I don't really think the last level's hard. The only levels that I think are actually tough is the second level and the fourth level. The mall is hard because you have to jump on the lollipops. And by the way, look at this. Bart's face gets to be on Mount Rushmore. But, yeah, jumping on the lollipops in the second stage definitely is hard. And then also, the hardest level by far is that museum level. Getting through that is really tough because of the platforming. Getting through the laser beams, getting through the dinosaur, like jumping on the bones of the dinosaur with those like, golden geese. And, yeah, that whole level is really difficult. But that is it. That is The Simpsons. Bart versus the Space Mutants. I don't think it's a bad game. I think it's just a hard game. So, thanks for watching, guys.